In this video, I'm going to explain six joints around shoulder girdle. These six joints are very, very important to move shoulder. Okay? First place is this place. This is sternoclavicular joint. Sternoclavicular joint. Wait a second. It is very far away from shoulder joint. However, movement of this joint is very, very important. If you think about it, this is clavicle, you know, then this is shoulder joint. When you move shoulder, clavicle, humerus, scapula needs to move together, right? If you elevate shoulder, clavicle needs to go elevation, right? Where is the axis of movement of clavicle? It's around here. So if this place gets tight, that can affect whole shoulder movement. This is very, very important place. Yet, this is very minor place, so oftentimes this joint is ignored. However, very important joint. This is sternoclavicular joint. Let's move on to next one. Next one is this area. This is acromioclavicular joint. Acromioclavicular joint. This joint is also very minor place, same as here, sternoclavicular joint. Yes, this joint doesn't move a lot. However, what happens, somebody got injury here, same as sternoclavicular joint. If this place gets injury, you can't move shoulder joint very well because this place is connection between clavicle and scapula. So this is also important place. Acromioclavicular joint. Let's move on to next one. Next one is actually not a bone-to-bone joint. It is right here. It is space between scapula and ribcage. This joint is called scapulothoracic joint. Scapulothoracic joint. As I said, this joint is not for bone and bone joint. Scapula and ribcage do not have bone articulation. There is only gliding surface between these two places. However, there are a few muscles between scapula and ribcage, such as serratus anterior, subscapularis. What happens if these muscles get adhesion? Or these muscles cannot function well? Maybe this gliding surface might be affected, so it can be immovable. What if scapula gets immovable? That affects shoulder joint, like these two joints. Scapula needs to move for shoulder movement. So this kind of a functional joint is very, very important. That said, serratus anterior and subscapularis in scapulothoracic joint are very, very important. Okay, this is such an important place for shoulder movement. Okay, next one. Next one is also kind of functional joint. This is not bone-to-bone joint as well. It's around here. You know, there is big muscle right here. Let's say this is deltoid. The joint is beneath deltoid. Let's say it's about here, beneath deltoid. What kind of joint is this? This is subdeltoid joint. Subdeltoid joint. There is bursa here. What is bursa? Bursa is like a lubrication system in joint and body that decreases friction between tissue and tissue. So let's imagine bursa is here to reduce friction because shoulder needs to move for multi-dimension, right? So there's something for lubrication, correct? So there's bursa. And this space is subdeltoid joint. This is also not a bone-to-bone joint. However, very important place. Next one is not also a bone-to-bone joint. It is this ligament complex around coracoid process. Some people consider this place as functional joint, like subdeltoid joint or scapular thoracic joint. Why is this ligament complex so important? As I said, in sternoclavicular and acromioclavicular joint, clavicle is very important for shoulder movement, and there are many ligaments between clavicle and acromion and coracoid process. What happens if this place gets tight? That can affect shoulder movement. So this ligamentous complex around coracoid process is very important. Ligament complex around coracoid. Okay, this is very important. I mean, everything is important in this video. Now let's move on to the last one. Last one is this place. Yay, this is glenohumeral joint. Glenohumeral joint. What is it? This is the shoulder joint. If you hear about shoulder joint, that's here. The joint between scapula and humerus. Of course, this joint is very important. It's crucial. It's the most important joint in shoulder. Yes, of course. But as I said, other five joints are equally important. Sternoclavicular, acromioclavicular, scapulothoracic, the ligamentous complex, and subdeltoid joint. If these five joints do not work properly, it's very hard to move glenohumeral joint. So I hope this video gives you new idea, new perspective for seeing shoulder joint. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.